everybody. Dr. Mark Trolice at Fertility CARE, the IVF Center here in Orlando, Florida. Nice to be with you all again. What a game last night. Oh my gosh. Everybody's a little bit more tired, but we all had fun last night watching the game. So I hope you all did. And today, the topic was, I have fibroids, and patients usually get a little bit nervous when I talk about that because fibroids are actually a tumor. And so when I say, the two things when we do an ultrasound that patients get nervous about, when I tell them they have a cyst, and when I say there's a fibroid tumor, okay? They're both benign, by the way, or at least a lot of cysts are benign. Rarely they're bad. So when we talk about fibroids, these are benign overgrowths inside the lining of, or inside the muscle of the uterus. That's where they start, okay? So fibroids used to be called leiomyomas or myomas, and they start with one cell and then they grow. And in the reproductive years, about 30% of women are going to be diagnosed with fibroids, more common in African-American women, but we'll see it increasing as the woman gets through their reproductive years. So what's the big deal about fibroids? Well, there are gynecologic problems with fibroids, and then there are reproductive problems with fibroids. Fibroids can also be completely asymptomatic. Women may not even know they have it unless we do an ultrasound, okay? But if it's symptomatic, it can cause abnormal uterine bleeding, so much so that it's so severe that it could even cause a need for a transfusion. They can cause pain, okay? Significant abdominal bloatedness and pressure on the bladder. And so removing the fibroid, called a myomectomy, is often the treatment for that. In terms of reproduction, this has been an area of a lot of controversy in the medical literature because for years we thought fibroids were definitively associated with infertility, and then we started taking a look at the location of the fibroids and then the size of the fibroids. So let me just try to summarize it by saying this, okay? When we look at the uterus, we have the inside of the uterus, the inside of the cavity called the endometrial cavity. Then there's the muscle of the uterus, and then there's the outside, okay? So when the fibroids are, I wonder if I should just bring this over. Let me see if we can get that. Do we have that, Christina? You can see it? Okay, all right. So this is the uterus right there, okay? This is a fibroid inside the muscle of the uterus, or the myometrium, growing out. Same thing over here. And then this is the inside of the uterus. This is where we have the major concern reproductively. When fibroids are inside the uterine cavity or pushing and distorting the uterine cavity, those are the ones that we feel confident about that can reduce implantation and increase miscarriage, okay? For years, we thought that if it was in the muscle of the uterus, even if the cavity was normal, and if the size of the fibroid is more than 4 to 5 centimeters, that would also cause a problem. But more recently, that doesn't seem to be the case. So the only fibroids that we're really promoting removing are the ones that are inside the uterine cavity, called submucous fibroids, or those in the muscle of the uterus, called intramural, that are pushing and distorting the cavity, okay? Why are fibroids a problem? Well, it's not only a question of getting pregnant, it's a question of the health of the pregnancy, because as we said earlier, miscarriages is higher. But also preterm labor and delivery are a higher rate. And so it's probably occupying space inside the uterus, and there's only so much size the uterus can grow, that it triggers the brain to thinking that it's full term and it goes into preterm labor. Another thing is the fibroid at term can also cause a separation of the placenta, the afterbirth, from the wall of the uterus, called an abruption, and that could increase bleeding at the time of delivery. So if we're certain that we need to remove the fibroids, often we'd like to be able to do it through the hysteroscope. We put a telescope, this is a one-day surgery, telescope through the cervix, through the vagina, the cervix into the uterine cavity, and remove the fibroid, okay? That's the easiest way to go. Very simple outpatient procedure, same day you're home, and recovery very, very swift, okay? The other type of fibroids would involve going through the tummy, either through the laparoscope or often robotically through multiple scopes incisions, and rarely open incision, which is a major abdominal surgery. And then we make an incision in the uterine cavity and to carve out and remove that fibroid. So there's always a weakening of the uterus, the muscle of the uterus, whenever you invade it to remove the fibroid. The least invasive is when it's inside the cavity. Certainly much more invasive when you have to go through the outside of the uterus. That could increase the risk of uterine rupture at the time of delivery, so often a cesarean section is recommended. So fibroids are a problem that we see and want to address as part of the evaluation, and we want to give you the proper information so that you can make an informed decision about which direction to go. So bottom line is that not all fibroids are symptomatic, not all fibroids are going to impair your fertility, but certainly when there's an impact of the uterine cavity, surgery is recommended, and usually about up to 3 months of uterine healing before pursuing pregnancy. And then we can, hopefully you can conceive naturally or through the treatment that we offer. So until next week, this is Dr. Mark Trolice from Fertility CARE, the IVF Center here in Orlando. We'll see you in a week. Have a fantastic week.